pushed back the surgery. I'm getting surgery on Friday, so I just decided to come out here and give it everything I have today.
Is that right? What's involved in the surgery and how long do you think you're going
to
have?
It's similar to the same injury that Michael Crabtree from Texas Tech had and Julio Jones. Just going to require a screw to put in my fifth metatarsal, my foot, in about 4 to 6 weeks recovery time. You know, it's pretty common from what I understand.
Right foot or left foot?
My left foot.
Yeah.
Do you think it hurt you in terms of what you did today? I mean, could you feel it at all as you were out there?
I definitely felt it, but I don't believe it hurt me too bad, being that the scouts knew my condition already, and I think I gained a few brownie points coming out here on a broken foot and doing everything I could today.
How do you think you performed?
And go through these drills when you do have a broken foot?
You just got to push through it. You know, it's always in the back of your head. You don't want to make the wrong move like I did at the combine and tweak it and not be able to run at all. But you know, I just put it out of my head and convince myself the pain is only temporary.
How do you feel being back here on the field with some of your old fellows?
I felt pretty good, you know, seeing Coach Berry and Mr. Hyman and everybody, you know, felt good to be back. You know, this has been my home for the past 4 years, so, you know, it felt good. You know how I feel anywhere, and I appreciate Coach Berry and Mr. Hyman allowing me to participate in Pro Day today.
Your career obviously didn't end like you had hoped. Were you at all nervous about coming back here, given that?
I wasn't nervous at all because it's always been a family atmosphere. You know, just like it's kind of like when you mess up at home. You know, you're disciplined, but you're not scared to go back home. You know, home is where the heart is, and this is where my heart was.
Wes, I saw Spurrier speak with you at some point today out of midfield. What was that conversation like?
Oh, he just told me good luck, asked how I was doing, you know, small talk. You know, Coach Spurrier, you know, he's got recruitment, so, you know, I know Coach Spurrier, so we just talked, and he just wished me the best of luck, and I wish him the best of luck on next season.
I think a lot of fans will wonder how did you not
Because at the end of the day, everything I did was my own fault. You know, I don't have any bitterness at all because I was able to actually take classes here and be a part of what was going on. Even though I wasn't physically on the field, my teammates and the coaches made me feel like I was every bit a part of it because, you know, I was practicing up until the last week of off-season training and off-season workouts. So it was good to be a part of, you know, the guys going through such a magnificent season this year. So I don't have any hard feelings at all.
Weslye, what's more important to you, proving to people that you're a good player or that you're a good person?
That I'm a good person because I think, you know, my athletic ability was never in question. But then after a few mistakes I made, you know, my character became in question. I wanted to prove that I have good character, you know, that I'm not a character. So that's what I wanted to prove, and that's the thing, that's the point I'm trying to get across, because I don't believe my athletic ability was ever in doubt.
How do you go about doing that and repairing your injury?
Just one step at a time. Nothing I can say right there at this point. You know, it's all about action, how I carry myself from this point on, how I handle situations on and off the field. And just, you know, being seen, not heard.
What's the biggest lesson you've learned going through all your trials?
The biggest lesson is always keep the faith and always be truthful, you know. Be truthful in whatever you do and let the chips fall where they may, because, you know, fabricating a story or not even telling the whole truth is just the same as telling a lie. And being truthful is the biggest thing. You know, a man is only as good as his word, and that's what I've learned mostly.
Wes, how have the NFL people you've talked to received what happened to you? They know you didn't play last year. Are they still pretty high on what you can bring to teams?
I think, like I said, you know, they know about my athletic ability, yeah. But they want to be sure that they're not bringing in a player that's going to disrupt the team's chemistry in some kind of way off the field, anything like that. So I wanted to be sure that I removed all of those doubts from their head, that, you know, I made a mistake, I moved on from it, I matured from it 100%, and I'm ready to move on and play some football without any distractions off the field at all.
Do you think the interview process has been tougher for you than other guys that haven't had
it? I do. I do believe it's been tougher for me, but that was expected. You know, I brought it upon myself, and I handled it. I think I handled it very well because I knew what was coming. I knew the questions that were going to be asked of me, and I knew I had to answer them with my chin held high, so that's what I did.
How'd you first hurt your foot?
When I was training, you know, just training a little too hard. You know, I came down to Michael Johnson's facility in Dallas, Texas, and you know, I was a little overweight, and I just was going hard about three times a day, and you know, I fractured while I was down there.
So like an overuse injury?
Yeah,
it didn't happen on one particular jump, or did it?
I don't believe so. They said it was a stress reaction at first, and then it turned into a full fracture after.
And when did you break it?
About the end of January.
And you got surgery the next week?
I had surgery on this Friday.
This Friday.
So even the challenges of, you didn't even think you were going to be a part of the draft for a little while, you break your foot, I mean, it was kind of adding up even in January.
It was very tough. You know, I kind of got a little bit depressed at one point because, you know, I wasn't able to come back to USC for another season, and I tried to move on, and you know, they said I wasn't eligible for the draft, and I was going to have to wait till 2012, and then, you know, I broke my foot, and it was just a lot to handle at one time, but I just kept my faith. I like Coach Spurrier, one of the biggest lessons he taught me was to control what I could control. You know, I couldn't control any of the other stuff that was going on, but I continued to train, continued to do what I had to do to prepare for this moment, and I did everything I could.
Nice doing your surgery.
Definitely got
it. What now? What are you expecting
from him? Hopefully get the surgery done this Friday. The recovery time is not that long from what I understand, so I'm going to take a few weeks off. If I meet with teams, then that's what I'll do. Just prepare for the draft and keep my spirits high.
Are you hearing around at all?
No, I'm not here. I heard it. I've heard everything from second round to undrafted, so I can't really listen to that stuff. You know, just go out there and do what I can do, control what I can control, and I guess we'll see on draft day.
Wes, have you heard anything else from the NCAA, or is that inquiry all over now?
I haven't heard anything from them personally. You know, since my last meeting with them when I went up to Indianapolis, I haven't heard anything personally, but I think they got everything they needed from me, so that's all I can vouch for. Yeah.
Is this an important day for you, just in terms of kind of you're here on campus again, just a symbol in a way?
It's very important for me, especially being I didn't end my collegiate career the way I wanted to, and I didn't end the combine the way I wanted to, so I had to come out here with a new attitude and just do everything I could today, and it's good to be back on, you know, where it all started.
What do you want people here, the fans here, to remember about Wes Saunders?
Try to forget about it. You know, the last few months I was here, you know, I never meant to bring any a bad reputation to the school. You know, I love the school. There's a reason I came here. The fans have been so supportive of me. I can't thank the fans enough, because, you know, without them, I don't think I would have made it. You know, everything that happened, and around the time I was suspended, you know, Ken McKinley killed himself, and there's just a lot going on, and the fans were with me 100%. You know, there were some people, you know, bad mouthing me, but you can expect that. But I don't want them to remember me as a guy who tried to bring the program down or anything like that, because I love the school.
You have any regrets, though? I mean, on or off the field, you know?
I do regret a lot of things, you know, but I can't dwell in the past. I just can hope to focus on the future and make better decisions in the future.
How was the decision made for you to be here today? How did you come to that?
I just asked Coach Spurrier if I could be a part of it. He said yes, and I was going to be here.
Were you surprised? Did you know what to expect on that?
Being that things I've done in the past, you know, Coach Perry had every right. Coach Perry, Coach Hyman had every right not to allow me to be here, but they did, and I appreciate it, and I just came here, and I owed it to them to do my best.
Set your necklace on the ring.
Yeah.
They want you to leave it. Did the shoe change have anything to do with the foot?
What do you mean?
Change shoes for the foot?
Oh.
Did it have to do with your foot, or was that just a comfort issue?
It was just a comfort issue running on this turf. You know, I got the Nike Waffle Races or something like that, and I wanted more traction, so I just changed the shoes.